Great street to Lake Charm area and the wooded area and the open pasture fields here. We were getting indications of, we weren't sure what kind of indications were, but the canine handlers were telling us, hey, why don't we go ahead and search this area here? And they were using scent articles for this information. They requested that we call Volusia County Canine, Sheriff's Department Canine Bloodhounds out. We did that. They responded. And they also searched an area there, and we ended up with negative results, not finding anything. So that's where we ended up last night, and we're going to be starting up our search today. So the priorities for the – well, one other thing that I want to add about last night is the Seminole County Sheriff's Department alert helicopter patrolled for 40 minutes at a time about six times throughout the night looking for any type of heat signature or any other movement after we got everybody out of the woods to see if there was any type of movement from anybody other than animal life, and they detected no movement in those 40-minute patrols. The priorities for today are we're going to put some more dog teams out there with individual search and rescues. Law enforcement search and rescue are going to be going with them, and they're going to be concentrating in an area, what we are calling zones 3 and 4, which is directly to the north, a little bit northeast of the command post. In that very heavily thicketed area right in front of where we the most likely place that Nadia would have gone into. Again, I stress that we are continually coming in contact with areas that are very dense and thick, and it's not likely somebody went through there. The other thing is the Florida Department, the range and water for the state of Florida, took a boat out onto Lake Jessup yesterday. And tried to insert rescuers and dog from the north to the south, and realized that the water there that's typically only 1 foot deep turned out being almost 6 foot deep. And we don't even think we're going to put anybody in there because it's not likely anybody went into that area because we couldn't even insert rescuers into there. We are also going to now start compiling all the information that we've obtained. Through the last two days, almost three full days now, to make sure that with the map that we're using of the location, we're going to go back over everything to see where the searchers have already been, and we want to make sure that there's something or any area that we have not missed.
Chief, at this point, I know over the weekend you said you didn't expect any foul play here, but are you looking at sex offender registries, checking on sex offenders throughout Winter Springs right now?
Absolutely. Actually, what we're doing is, currently right now, what we're doing is very simply this. We have already, the first day, we checked all of the sexual predators and offenders within a five-mile radius. Checked, knocked on their doors. They were all cooperative. All but two we actually located. They weren't home or whatever, but every one of them were cooperated and actually let us search their homes. The other thing that we're doing is we're doing it countywide. We're in the process of doing it countywide. All sexual offenders, sexual predators, we're making contact with them and asking them to verify their whereabouts on Friday. So we're in the process of doing, and that's part of that secondary ongoing investigation.
Chief, based on the location that you found the bike, is it plausible that she got off the bike? I mean, was the bike sitting in a way where she may have gotten off the bike willingly, gone into the woods? Is that theory hold up?
Let me show you the scene. All right? A bicycle at the end of a cul-de-sac with one home off to the right-hand side and nothing but dense woods in front of you, on its kickstand, helmet taken off, and placed on the handlebar, just like somebody got off the bike to take a walk or to go into a house or anything like that. That's the scene that we have right now. And as every one of you all know, this search, as extensive as it has been, has turned up nothing at all. No clothing, no backpack, no shoes, nothing.
But there is some kind of scent maybe back there with the canines that they believe maybe she was back there in the woods.
The canines are telling us that with the scent articles that they have attained, that she was back there.
Describe, if you can, the conditions. I mean, pretty treacherous from what we've seen on the video. I mean, you have any swampland back there? What are the conditions like?
The searchers and the law enforcement personnel have been consistently in at least knee-deep water, going through brush, thorns, sticks, trees, and the foliage coverage up above for the helicopter is virtually impossible to see through.
Does any of this area have homeless camps or trails or anything like that?
We haven't come upon any homeless camps up there. Most of the time, we don't know that there's a homeless camp out there unless it's been reported to us and or we come upon it during a search like that. We have come upon no homeless camps, no other camps or anything out there in this whole search area.
You mentioned the heat-seeking cameras on the helicopters. Have those picked up anything, any images at this point?
The only images that they're picking up right now are wildlife, deer and other types of wildlife that are out there.
And how many hours were they up in the air yesterday searching the area?
Well, they were up last night after we pulled all of our searchers out of the woods. They were up six times for a total 40 minutes or a little bit more than 40 minutes each time doing their orbit.
How often are the searchers encountering alligators back then?
Right now, I haven't heard of an incident where we've encountered one that we were worried about other than one being in the nature. Most of them were on Lake Jessup, but as I'm sure you could understand.
Obviously, as each minute goes...
It's hard. I mean, the clock keeps ticking here.
Right.
And, you know, the question being on many people's mind, you want to think that she's alive, but you know, is it looking bleak right now?
Well, sure it is. Sure it is. But here's my point on that. I have a lot of experts out there that are helping me get through this, all right? Those experts are telling me that we are still in the live search phase because feasibly somebody could still be alive out there. So we're not in a rush to change this or to go into any different mode until the conditions dictate. You have to understand, we're in Florida, but we're in a time in Florida where it's not 100 degrees, 110 degrees out there. So until the experts or the people who know more than what I know tell me that we are no longer in a live search phase, we're going to continue it.
How crucial has the help been from Nadia's sister? I know she's been giving you a lot of information over the weekend, her family. Talk about that if you can.
Right. The information that she provided to us gave us some good information, some other articles that we needed to look for. As far as something, if we're out there on the search pattern and we find an article on the ground, like I mentioned over the weekend, if we found a particular type of a candy wrapper or something like that, they knew that that was in the house. So that would tell us, hey, maybe she's been out here eating this candy or something.
And nothing, no finds yet.
That's what I'm saying. We have found nothing out there, nothing but wildlife, mud, and other researchers. And, of course, I've mentioned before, people who are inserting themselves into our search area without checking in. The information that she provided to us, and I need to clarify something on that, was that she had another little video camera with her, and of course that she had some areas that she had been with Nadia out there, and she took us out to those areas, but those areas had already been searched. And one of them was that tree stand that I had talked to you about that we knew about on day one within a couple hours because the owner of the property who knows that area took us out there after he found out from some neighborhood kids that they have played out there. He was kind of like, I don't know how they found it, but after he found out that the neighborhood kids had found it and had been out there, he took us out there to it. The point of clarification that I want to make is it was first reported that she might have had a survival manual. But we've since learned it was not a survival manual, more as just a book. It's called Meet Lainey Holland is the name of the book. And in that book, it talks about an explorer going out and tracking wildlife and trying new experience and recording factoids. So it really wasn't a survival manual as we originally thought it was. It was just a book that piqued her interest, and that's probably why she was interested in the wildlife and going out and recording it.
For people who might see this and think, search, oh, I want to help, what is your response to that?
That response has been so overwhelming that I wish I could use everybody, but the situation here is what we're using right now is trained law enforcement, trained search and rescue, and trained search dogs. If we start getting other people out in there that don't have any training, now I got to maintain a staging area for them to wait at. We do have a list. The list is full. We have not had to use that list for volunteers right now. I don't anticipate having to use that list just because of the professional organization that we have out there right now that do this, unfortunately, it seems like on a regular basis in the state of Florida with some of these kids going missing and stuff. And some of these teams that are out here have also been on some of these other high-profile cases, and I'm glad to have them.
Thanks, Chief.
Thank you, Chief.